and we're back out on the tube once more, this time on the dark blue line of the tube, as we do the least used station on the Piccadilly line.
North Ealing, which is really located in East Ealing, opened in 1903 and was originally part of the District Railway, not becoming part of the Piccadilly until 1932. It sits in Zone 3 of the travel zones and very much has a rural charm to it, which is in keeping with its least used status.
It feels slightly odd because the station is tucked down this little side road here, and there's a fairly busy road here and then a very busy main road over there. So it certainly seems like it's in a busy suburban urban area, but because it's tucked away, it has its least used charm about it.
And before you enter the station, you can't help but notice that it's got a car park to the side of it.
The thing about North Ealing car park is that it's really handy, this sounds like an obvious thing, for getting into the centre of town. By that I mean I know some people who definitely drive here from like Zone 6, Zone 7 and beyond in South, Southwest, West London, but they come to here, Zone 3, park the car and then nip into Zone 1, centre of town on the Piccadilly line. Two things. One, historical note, I want to make it known that in 2019 it costs £4.50 a day to park here. I feel like every year we should come back and see how much it's gone up by. Also, it might just be the only tube station car park to have an electric charging point, unless you know better. I know Epping. I bet Epping's got one. But let me know in the comments what other tube station car parks have charging points for electric vehicles.
I headed inside the station to check out North Ealing's facilities, and there's a gents' toilets here,
which is handy because I genuinely need to go. So whilst I do that, we'll have a look at what other facilities there are here.
North Ealing is served by two bus routes and also has a bike rack, dot matrix indicators, multiple help points and a solitary litter bin, sadly not blowing in the breeze. The platforms also have attractive hanging baskets with flowers in, oh, and there's this nice old clock as well. The labyrinth is also in an obvious spot, it's just screwed to a wall on the westbound platform. But what about this? What looks like a heritage sign?
One thing to note, going down to the westbound platform, there's this delightful sign here that says to trains for Harrow and Uxbridge, but that is not a Piccadilly line original, that is from the Metropolitan line from about the 1910s, maybe 1920s, and it was moved here much later, so that's a sign from the Metropolitan line, not from the Piccadilly.
Now, neither of the platforms at North Ealing is step-free, but it is on the list of stations due to have an upgrade to become step-free in the next few years. The most steps are when you have to cross over to the eastbound platform. You have to go up, across, and down the steps of the nice footbridge. But when you get to the other side, there's something even nicer waiting for you.
There's also this charming waiting, I don't want to call it a waiting room, I call it a waiting shelter, that's on the eastbound platform. A lot of North Ealing's charm comes from the fact that the line from Acton Town up to Rainers Lane and beyond was originally part of the District Railway, now the District Line. But then the Piccadilly Railway, now the Piccadilly Line, later took it over. And all of the station buildings along that line, so like Sudbury Town, my favourite, going up to Rainers Lane, were all redesigned and done as Charles Holden or Charles Holden-esque type buildings, apart from this one. Don't know why. North Ealing retains its kind of like little villagey backwater station style building and the waiting shelter like this. It's really nice. So in terms of service pattern, during the peak, Monday to Friday, it gets 12 trains in the morning peak and 12 trains in the evening peak in each direction, off peak, and at weekends it drops to just 6 trains an hour. More importantly, what does that do to the passenger statistics? Just how least used is North Ealing? Let's have a look.
Going by the set of statistics that we're using in this series, North Ealing gets 827,000 passengers a year. That's just over 2,000 per day, and this is how it compares with the other lines in this series.
So there you go, the least used station on the Piccadilly, getting very close to the end now. Press subscribe, keep watching, and we will eventually get to the least used station on the whole of the Underground.